Okay, this is a short exercise teaching you how to start increasing the length of your torso in the lower hemisphere from your sternum all the way through your first quartile to start healing your hips and working the first quartile correctly related to your hips. It's a nice exercise for a bunch of different ways in, including our spiraling and our rotation, but we want to increase the front line because most of our hip congestion comes because of our tucking of the pelvis, slouching forward, and kind of general tension from even sitting or from doing too much upper body and core work. So you're going to start by laying on your stomach, and it's prone. So you're kind of laying down with your hands crossed and your chin on your hands. And the simple action is going to start with taking your left leg and lifting it, and we're going to twist and let it drop over our bodies. Now, a lot of times we tend to be tight in that front body, but I want you to start working to release the leg from your equatorial line or your sternum. So we're going to let the leg be the counterweight. You're just going to let it hang and pull on you. Instead of lifting for any type of glute action yet, we're going for the length. The weight of the leg is tractioning my torso and opening up the length and distance between your sternum and your pubic bone. With fascia, you always want to go with the point of force rather than retracting away from it. So you're not trying to hold your core. You're going to let the leg drag you and exhale. Focus for about four of these on letting your leg pull on you and letting your fascia pull towards the end of your leg. You'll get a nice stretch. After about four, bring your awareness up to your upper hemisphere. At the same time that your leg is pulling on you, you'd like to feel that your ribs are pressing and spreading forward. You can even pull your hands towards your body to lengthen and get that feeling so that your ribs are not pulling back with the leg, but working in opposition and distributing the tension through there. Good, let's come back. Take the right leg up, rotate it over, and you're gonna let it drop. As it drops behind you, we'll do four of the drops hanging off your bones. So in this exercise, we're trying to allow the leg to really start lengthening the torso and stretching it. I'm kind of exaggerating, so you can see that there's a pull that lengthens down to my leg, and there's also a lengthening that goes back. After you do about four, focusing on your lower hemisphere, just go up to your consciousness in the upper hemisphere and let your mid-back, which we call your third quartile, to move forward and stretching up to the opposite direction. You're creating kind of this spiral, and it starts to open nicely into the hip, the leg, and the low back. This is a great place to feel your first quartile, which, we'll do the other side again, is not pulling up. We don't contract, it compresses. And as it compresses layer by layer, it actually is what gives you that stretch. You're always trying to open the hip from your equatorial line. Here's where your tissue orients itself for animation, for movement. This is where it goes for locomotion. So we're going to get into the animating tissues of the exercise, and then we'll go more into the locomotive range of motion in the hip. So just let the body drop, close your eyes, and start to pattern out how the leg draws and pulls on you. You'll actually feel a stretch up in your upper hemisphere, up in your ribs, and try to feed that first quartile, front, back, and down. Remember to relate to your leg like it's a tube rather than a stick. Your fascia will start to feel like it actually has volume as it's pulling down and through you. So you're hitting multiple layers of fascia at the same time. To the other side, you're gonna roll, the right leg goes over. And you just kind of repeat this action. In GST, every time you repeat, it's a chance to refine. We don't do reps to be redundant and hit the tissue for tone. You just want to go in, and every time you can find a little bit more. There, I got a little bit more release. And three, and two, and one, and release. Great. Now that you've opened up your spiral line, I'm going to have you come up, widen your feet, Then you're gonna put your hands in front of you, and you're gonna push your hands across the floor. I'm showing you that if I push my hands towards my front, where my fingers are pointing, you also see that I would simultaneously be pushing back into my hips. Okay, so we're gonna do this a couple times. Check a couple things. When you push, that you're not pushing back into your ribs. This is a big habit of people who have that tight rib cage from all the crunches and sitting. When you push, you wanna actually try to slide as if you're taking and pushing the energy through your hips. I usually use the analogy of like de-pantsing, because we need decompression in that lumbar spine. If I push my ribs back, you can see that it goes into my back, okay? Into the low back, rather than moving it through into my legs. Watch the difference. You're gonna have to practice this, target practice. You push your hands forward and do not let your ribs go back, else you feel it loading into your low back. Now, do it the correct way. You're gonna push your hands forward and you drop your third quartile, so your ribs, instead of pushing back, actually drop. And then you can feel that you can get stretch down to your legs. Now, here's a little bit of a trick. We're trying to create decompression in the lumbar spine, but you're gonna feel a stretch in the front of your hip. What I want you to do is keep a fixed point with your toes. If you can see my toes, I'll move forward a little bit. Oh, cramp. A little bit of tension in my toes. I can actually use my feet to help traction, and this will start to decompress the hip and allow for the tissue to start moving. And I get a big stretch across my hip flexors, but I get a fascial stretch that almost feels a little bit like a rug burn going across it. That's okay. We're starting to move the glide of that tissue that's stuck. So the hands pushing with the feet pulling, you start to see how I'm decompressing my spine, and I can really feel it in the front of my hip. Now, do that three more times just to refine the action. Press. Feel how your spine starts to work like a conveyor belt. You do want to check that you're not tucking or that your ribs are pushing back. You'll feel a lot of pressure in your pubic bone and in your low back if you do that. The point is to teach the tissue in the spine how to slide past your pelvis and therefore stretching your hip. So we push. Then I pull my toes up and it comes forward. And under tension, I'm still animating tissue. Good, let's do one more. So it's not a big movement in terms of the pressure, but you are doing tons of manipulation in the tissues right in the front of your hip, okay? Now, feel your hip bones. I'm gonna keep a little bit of pressure on my hands, and you're going to take your right hip bone and try to arc it into the floor, and then release. And then left hip. And I actually can push my hands now. I'm gonna push my right hand into the floor this way and wide, and I can get a stretch on that hip. And then I'm gonna bring it back. Then I push my left hand, and I'm going to push my left hip bone. You're seeking for that bone. We really want the hips to heal, and that happens by letting the pelvis feed both the leg bone and the spine bone evenly. If you lock down like a tuck, you can't actually get your spine to travel weight through the hip, and you actually push your hip forward in that hip socket. Doesn't feel good. So push your left hand and get your left hip to drop your hip bone. You can even do a little bit of a rotation to feel that. Once you push into your bones, you're going to pull your first quartile through your leg. So I push into my bone this way. Then I can feel my first quartile and it like smushes down and pulls through my leg, and I can even initiate a little draw by flexing that foot again, showing you all these techniques in. So really, really nice stretch. Do it to the right one more time. Push your hip bone and then stretch, pulling the leg out of the socket. If there was a sound effect with the sound, it'd feel like your hip is just like decompressing instead of being jammed up into you. Then, if you can keep your heels on the ground, sometimes you can't because your hips are so tight. Two things, if you start feeling this in your low back, you can lower your angle of your upper body, still keep up on your elbows, but you'd be pushing from this versus pushing up like this, and that will change some of the tension in your low back. Check that you're releasing your front abdominals from your belly button to your pubic bone, because when they're totally tight, it racks on your hips and low back. and then pull back. Go into your child's pose. Do it with your traction that we practice, active traction. So I don't just sit into the pose, my hands are forward. I pull back. And this is a great place to also feel like you're deepening. So hip health comes not just from the opening and the flexibility, but how deeply your femur can push into your spine. What we don't usually realize is that when this leg bone pushes into the hip, it is simultaneously tractioning the spine. And when we tuck our pelvis under, we actually end up gripping down on the vertebra rather than tractioning it away. So pull your first quartile to lengthen and then release. Stretch your arms out. Inhale, stretch and release. And exhale and finish back. This is a great progression for learning, number one, how the lower hemisphere builds from length into strength through one continuum, taking you through the different actions of weight in the pelvis, stretching out into the motions of the legs, and being able to layer the information from the socket and the skeletal system up through the animation of the tissue and on into the health of your whole body, and especially in the hips and lower leg and the way they're governed by your first quartile. If you like what you learned in this video, please make sure you leave comments and ask questions. Join our conversation. We love that you're finding us about all things fascia with GST Body. Please find us anywhere that you connect. You can find us on Instagram, on our website, www.gstbody.com. We really want to focus on fascia as the answer to all things body, for body care, for optimization, for healing. And we hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for coming by.